yet another episode of the series beckons you. Well, this episode, at the very least, contains a ton of fun stuff. The teacher I'm going to be interacting with today is full of surprises. One thing you will come across in this discussion is the quality of adaptability. You will see how she blended herself into the subject, which initially wasn't even a forte, and now students like me are grateful that we learned from her. Her classes are engrossing storytelling sessions rather than just being her average rigid classes. She has done fashion designing in the past for many celebrities, which could be a possible career option for many of us. I love attending her classes because they're just so fun, so full of participation. And well, who doesn't love stories? So before we move on, let's hear what my friends have to say about this teacher.
Vijeta ma'am is someone who understands the students very well and very fun. She makes sure that she understands everything that the student goes through and makes it easier for them at all costs.
I think Vijeta ma'am is a great teacher. She's always very kind and energetic in class, and I love the way she teaches us. She also loves to interact with her students.
Vijeta ma'am is such a good teacher, and she explains very well. And ma'am is so kind. Even if I don't get a question, or even if it's a very silly question that I ask, ma'am never shouts at me. Ma'am tries to explain it to me in very nice words and in very simple words. Ma'am is very kind and is very humorous. We always have a good laugh, either in the starting of the period, the end, or in the middle of the period.
So ma'am, for all our viewers out there, if you don't mind, can you please tell us who all are there in your family?
Yeah, me, my husband, and I have two children. My daughter is in 11th grade, and my son is in 8th grade.
So ma'am, when you are not being pestered by us at school, what are the things you like to do to relax? Like, you know, what are your hobbies?
I like to dance, I like to sing, I think these are the two hobbies which I say. Sometimes I love to read books, not very passionate about reading books, but yeah, apart from my curriculum books and all, I like to read some Sudha Murthy type, I mean very light books, not the heavy stuff.
So ma'am, what's a typical Saturday evening like for you?
Oh, nowadays don't ask me, it's all the household work, I think. all you know, kitchen work, all cookery things, and my kids love to eat different kind of stuff, so I'm always in the kitchen and sometimes, you know, doing my all lesson plans and what I need to teach. Like now, I mean, today only I was making the form, paper, review papers, all the discussion with other teachers or something like that. We had a meeting today morning at 9 o'clock. So, it's balancing, I mean, between both the things. I try my best actually to give maximum time to my family. But wherever is needed, then professional things also.
So, ma'am, hypothetically, if not a teacher, what other profession would you have chosen? Mujhe lagta hai ki aap TV anchor banti, but not a TV anchor, what would be your dream job?
See, actually, I have done even the fashion designing also. I have done a diploma in fashion designing. So, I have done from NIFT. So, that was also my passion. I would have even gone for the singing thing as a singer. Even I have done masters in music also. So, I would have even liked done that profession also, chosen that. But I am very much happy now that I have chosen this as a profession, because with this I am always with the youth, actually with the young generation, and I, you know, sometimes I learn from my students even for to handle my own children, my own kids, and sometimes I learn, it's a vice versa, sometimes I learn from my children how to handle my students. So I am very much happy and satisfied with this profession.
So ma'am, teaching is a very tough job with 25 students in the class, plus the headmistress and the principal. And then most importantly, you have the overactive moms also breathing down the teacher's neck. So what is the biggest challenge you've ever faced in your journey as a teacher?
Actually, to be very honest, Rishit, I have always loved it, loved teaching, and I think I just try to make my friends, you know. I mean, fortunately, I have been teaching, you know, to the 8th graders, 7th graders, 9th graders. So then I connect with them and I try to be a little more friendly with them, and as such, honestly, I have always got a good feedback and I have never had an issue with the parents. So, I never had a challenge kind of stuff that mujhe bahut difficulty ho rahi hai. Ha, some parents, some children, I mean those who are from being teaching actually Hindi in a South India, it was a challenge for me. Initially, you know, I was not a Hindi. Actually, I'm not a Hindi teacher. For you to be, you know, I'm not. I have done a master's in education. I have done in music. But when I joined this school, they found that we need a Hindi teacher like you. Those who are so much fluent in Hindi, because any South Indian learning, even doing master's in Hindi, also will not be that
fluent.
Comfortable or a fluent the way you are. So in those days I joined Deans in 2009. So there were not many North Indian teachers. So very few teachers were from North India. So they, you know, almost fixed me that ma'am said, Shanti ma'am offered me that you have to be a Hindi teacher, can you be? And I was reluctant actually a bit, because in North India being a Hindi teacher they will say, oh, you are teaching Hindi, like that. So I was a bit reluctant, ma'am, should I take that or should I not? But she said, you are very good in that, so please don't say no to me. I said, okay, ma'am, done. Then I think I have been now teaching in Hindi in this school since past 10 years. So, and I am liking it because now it has become my forte, it has become my, you know, I feel that I was made for this only. I think Shanti ma'am chose the right thing. Maybe she must have seen the thing in me. So she said, you better go ahead with my Hindi. You need to be careful.
Ma'am, I'm very glad
that you
are our Hindi teacher. Bane.
Chalo, thank you.
So ma'am, at the same time, hum jaise bachchon ke saath jo pure time masti karte the class mein, it would have its own set of hysterical moments. So can you share the funniest, craziest stuff pulled off by a student in your class?
तुम्हारी क्लास का एक बच्चा था एक बार बहुत साल पहले ही, बट आई मीन है देयर आर मेनी इंसिडेंट्स एक्चुअली, बट मुझे लगता है मैं उनको, जैसे मेरे पास ट्रबलसम चिल्ड्रन भी रहे हैं, मेरे पास आपके ग्रेड कितने, आपसे जो सीनियर है जो ऑलरेडी पास आउट कर चुके हैं, उनमें से एक बच्चा था, आई मीन, बट देर आर किड्स हु विल इवन क्रॉस देयर लिमिट्स, देन आई नो हाउ टू हैंडल देम, एंड मोर ओवर there are some students जिनको सारे school जो है वो बदनाम करता है कि नहीं नहीं this child is like that, you know, this child is not a good child, it's always notorious, you know, notorious, I mean you know the difference between famous and notorious.
Yes,
notorious children बहुत मिले हैं मुझे, जो लोग मिलते हैं कि all the best Vijayata, you got this child as a student, but I feel I don't want to criticize that person in front of the whole class, and I think within few months he gels so comfortably that I have not even faced, I mean those kind of tantrums, they don't show me as such what I have felt. Ki, there are many students those who say, oh, aapke class mein ye hai, aapke class mein wo hai. So, but I have felt aisa nahi hai ki maine kahi bachon ko daanta nahi hai, tumne bhi dekha, I scored them also, but I still feel that I feel for them actually, maybe for any children. So maybe I have never faced that kind of issue. Yes, ek bar ek bachche ne has bitten me on my hand.
That's a great ka.
Passed out ho gaya hai. But I mean that one child bitten me here, and that was the saddest thing I have ever had, ever experienced. That child was getting irritated because I was telling him to submit their notebooks, and that child with full crazy thing, he just came, he holded my hand, he bit me literally.